I can run. Sweet. Oh, wow. Moki Town. Look at this place. Holy crap. They did an amazing job in RPG Maker. This place looks amazing. Hello, world! Squirrels here, and I am so excited for the episode I've got planned for you guys today. This Let's Play of Pokemon Uranium Version. That's right, you didn't mishear me. I'm talking about Pokemon Uranium Version. If you're thinking to yourself, oh, what's that? I've never heard of that Pokemon game before. It's because it's actually a fan-based game. So this is a fan-created game. It is not an official game by Nintendo, Game Freak, the Pokemon Company, etc. That said, I don't believe they're an affiliation with them in any way. You know, the copyrights and all the ownerships and all that still belong to their respective parties. You'll see the description and all that jazz. Anyway, so really excited for this game. It looks like an awesome game. There have been several Pokemon games over the years, many in fact, that are great games, standalone games, that fans have built themselves just because, you know, they get a cool idea and they decide to make it. And today we're talking about Pokemon Uranium Version. That said, it's actually like 9 years in the making, believe it or not. I don't recall any, you know, news on it years ago. I wasn't really following it or the development of it, but apparently it's been 9 years in the making. And what's cool is looking at the patch notes, I actually found out that they added in Pokemon all the way up to 6th gen. I don't know, you know, how many of those Pokemon are available in the game, or how common or uncommon certain Pokemon are throughout generations 1 through 6. But even cooler part is that they've actually gone through and created 200, that's right, 200 additional Pokemon that are completely created by them, that were not created by Nintendo in any way, shape, or form. And they've even gone ahead and added a new typing called Nuclear Type. So just, there's a whole bunch of new content in this, a whole new region to explore, new features, and so on. They actually included online play as well, just like if you were playing a game on the 3DS, which I think is awesome for a fan-based game. There's just so much to talk about in this game, but I don't want to waste any more time. So let's go ahead, and without any further ado, I give you guys Pokemon Uranium Version. Alright, if you're still with us, here we are, getting into the game here. Hit space to continue. That was a pretty sweet opening cinematic, considering, you know, it was built with a RPG Maker XP, which At least I believe it was. That's what I've read across the internet. So let me go in here first, and I'm going to modify some of these sound settings. Let's move the volume down a little bit here, and some of the, just so that we don't need the music super loud. There, that's hopefully going to be better for you guys. And now I'll turn it up or turn it down if I see that the volume levels appear to be a little wonky. Let's see. Screen size, we'll leave that. I like it the way it is on my screen. For you guys, it doesn't really make a difference, so... Alright. So let's do this. New game. Choose your game mode. That's pretty cool. I did read about this. I forgot about it, though. And I know that some other fan games do include some Nuzlocke mode and some other modes as well. But we're just going to do a regular playthrough, so regular mode. And if you're not sure what a Nuzlocke is, we go over some of the rules in our Soul Link series. Maybe I'll provide a link somewhere up there if you want to go check out the Soul Link series. But otherwise, here we go. Sure you want to play this mode? Of course I am. Huh? Who is it? Oh, hello there. Welcome to the world of Pokemon. So classic, except he doesn't look like a professor. My name is Bambo. But if you find that hard to pronounce, you can just call me the Pokemon Professor. So he is a Pokemon Professor, apparently. You're the kid who's applying for a job, right? Great. Want the lowdown on what you'll be doing? Alright, so there's adventure controls, reconfigure controls. So let's look at adventure. I'll have you journey across the region collecting specimens for my research. Along the way, you're sure to encounter all kinds of people. Some will be willing to cooperate and some not, but you should try to be friendly with everybody. Aww. We don't want a bad reputation, right? Well, I guess if we're representing a company together. People will ask for your help solving mysteries or lending them a hand when they're down. And it won't be easy. There's dangers everywhere. There are dangers everywhere? I guess leave it to fan-based games. We'll call it due to translation. Whether it be wild creatures or people with ill intent, you'll need to be on your guard. But keep a clear head on your shoulders. Keep a clear head on your shoulders, kid, and I'm sure you'll pull through just fine. Want the lowdown on what you'll be doing? Nah, no info needed. Let's keep on going. That's a new Pokemon. We humans share this world with creatures known as Pokemon. More than mere animals, Pokemon possess astonishing powers and remarkable intelligence. People and Pokemon coexist in many ways. Some Pokemon are kept as pets, others help us with work, and still others are used in battle by trainers such as yourself. But there's so much we still don't know about Pokemon. That's my job. I study Pokemon for a living. Specifically, I'm an expert on Pokemon elements. Every Pokemon has an elemental type, and each type has its own strengths and weaknesses. But why do they exist? Are there new types of Pokemon we haven't discovered yet? But I'll tell you more at your first day on the job. Report to my lab tomorrow to get your first Pokemon. Now, if you just fill out this form here. Oh, that's cool how they did that. Who are you? They all look like chicks. I'm gonna say that that's the most male-looking person, so we're gonna go with that. Are you sure? Yes. I'd like to know your name. Please tell me. Well, of course we all know my name. My name be Skwirls. Alright. Enter to confirm. Cool. Your name is Skwirls? Yes. Skwirls, are you ready? Your journey, your story, is about to unfold. I guess we'll see how complex this plot line's gonna be, huh? Your future is a blank slate. You, together with your Pokemon, are going to fill it. There will be challenges and thrills, and you're bound to make exciting discoveries. Let's go. Exciting discoveries? More bitter discoveries than No Man's Sky? 10 years ago, Squirrel's family lived in Beale Beach City. The largest city in Tandor. So Tandor is the name of the new region here in this game, in case you haven't figured that out. Their father, Kellen, was a brave and talented Pokemon Ranger. So I've noticed that they're saying he instead of he or there instead of his or hers. Their mother, Lucille, was a brilliant scientist and an expert on nuclear energy. Although they both worked demanding jobs, they always found time to spend at home with young squirrels. The Tandor region was at peace, and Lucille's company was working on a form of clean energy that would change the world. The future seemed bright, until... This is pretty cool. This is like very RPG-like, like Japanese RPG-like. Like it reminds me of like an old Final Fantasy game or something. It was an ordinary day at the nuclear power plant where Lucille worked. As part of a routine inspection, they brought in a specialist to take a look at the electrical system. Cameron, have you finished your diagnostics?
Yes, I have. Everything seems to be working perfectly. This generator you designed really does its job well, Lucille.
Excellent. If everybody has finished their work, we'll break for lunch.
I feel like something bad is about to happen. It's a nuclear power plant.
Boss? You might want to take a look at this.
Yep. There it is.
Strange. These temperature readings are far higher than normal. Either we need to reset the thermometer, or... The reactor is leaking a massive amount of heat.
It can't be the thermometer. I just checked that.
Because they just do that. So...
Kablammo.
Uh-oh.
There must be a breach in the reactor. At this temperature, in just a few minutes, we'll have a total meltdown.
Of course you will, because it's the beginning of a plot, and this is a nuclear power plant.
Everybody needs to evacuate. No! Lucille, you have to leave too.
Oh man. With Cameron's help, all of the scientists were able to escape unscathed, except Lucille. Well, this is sad. She was never seen again after that day. Well, if she was never seen again, then I'm putting my hands on, like, I'm putting money down now. I'm pretty sure we're gonna meet up with Mom later. The radiation leaking from the broken reactor made the surrounding area uninhabitable for many years, foiling any attempt to try and search for her.
Yep. So she's probably all, like, mutated. We're gonna find her, like, later on in the story, and she's gonna be all, like, crazy looking.
The loss of his wife had a profound effect on Kellen. His personality changed. He became cold and dedicated to his job. In time, he got promoted to chief of the Tandor Pokemon Rangers. Oh, that's cool. However, he became too busy to care for his child. Poor me. So, young Squirrels was sent to live with their elderly auntie in Moki Town. All right, Auntie. Auntie's health waned. Supporting a child was too much work for her. Fortunately, Ernest Bambo, the local Pokemon professor, was looking for a research assistant. Two kids from Moki Town applied, Squirrels and their childhood friend Theo. Can anyone say rival? It was common for youths at a certain age to receive a Pokemon and travel the region as a Pokemon trainer. And so, Squirrel's journey began. This is such a sad story. Like, Mom died, Dad doesn't have time for me, I'm with Auntie, but she's, like, too overworked. Oh, man. Squirrels, come downstairs, you are late. Oh, look at me, I can move. Oh, man, I can't move very fast, though. Can I run? Nope, I don't think I can. Alright, so let's check some stuff out. Cram full of books about Pokemon. Me and my Oten. Must be a new Pokemon. Gibolta's Big Adventure. New Pokemon. Quest for the Legends. I've read all these too many times. Okay. Or many times, rather. Pokemon Battle showing on TV. Whoa, one of the Pokemon just Mega Evolved. Okay, time to go. It's Nintendo Wii U. Oh, that's cool. But I hear they're coming out with a new system soon. Huh, that's funny. Anything on the PC? Ooh, look at that traditional sound. What do we want to do? Item storage. Is there anything in here? Potion! Bam! Withdraw. Thank you, Wolf, for reminding me that in Pokemon games, there's something in the PC. What do I want to do? Mailbox? There's no mail. Okay. Oops. Dah! What's the back button? Alright. So, apparently I gotta stop hitting spacebar so fast. That's cool. Alright, let's go downstairs.
Wow, look at my house, dude. Crazy. So apparently mom sleeps downstairs, that's cool. Anything in these? Aunties. Cram full of books. Okay, alright. Let's go talk to mom. Or auntie, rather. I really hope we get to walk faster soon. Squirrels, sweetie. Today's your big day, isn't it? Oh, I guess I'm an auntie, or an old auntie.
I can't help but feel glum, seeing my little one all grown up and leaving home. Oh, but only if only these old bones could do more so I could support us both. But we both know that you're ready for this. You and that boy Theo. Always following in your footsteps, that one. You've always been so capable, but I wonder about him. He is younger, after all. I'm sure his father Cameron wouldn't allow him to go unless he was sure. Anyway, to celebrate your big day, I got you a present. Go ahead and open it.
All right. Squirrels obtained the running shoes. Yes. All right, sweet. Instructions to run, hold Z. You can toggle auto run in the menu.
Sniffle. Oh, don't mind me, sweetie. I'm just an emotional old lady. If only your father were here right now. Well, I'm sure he's proud of you, too. And I'm positive you'll run into him during your adventure. Now, I shouldn't keep you longer. Say hi to that nice professor man for me, will you? And if you don't mind stopping by again after you get your first Pokemon, I'd love to see it. Good luck, sweetie.
All right. I can run.
Sweet.
Oh, wow. Moki Town. Look at this place. Holy crap. They did an amazing job in RPG Maker. This place looks amazing. Look at these towns, or these houses. Wow. Gorgeous. I should probably be talking to people, but I'm a little enthralled right now. Too dangerous to go without a Pokemon. Oh, that must be grass. Yeah, that must be grass. Okay. So let's see if we can't find the, what's this say? Town of Fresh Beginnings. Oh, who's this? I wonder what kind of Pokemon lives in this pond. Okay.
Oh, look at that Pokemon!
Alright, where's the, there's gotta be some place that looks like a professor's hut. That kind of looks like a bigger building. Oh. Hello, squirrels. Today is the day you and Theo receive your first Pokemon, isn't it? Oh, this is Cameron. That's right. Theo certainly was excited. I imagine you must be too. Ah, I remember that day all those years ago. Yes, I was a Pokemon trainer just like you once. I'm retired now, of course, but I still remember what it was like. It's an auspicious day, indeed. If you're looking for Theo, I'm afraid he's not here. He's already gone ahead to the Pokemon lab in the north of town. Ah, that's where it is, okay. He's not very patient, so you should probably hurry along and join him. Alright. Let's go check it out. It feels very much like a Pokemon game, traditionally, but also very much like a traditional RPG as well. It's very cool. Oh. Hey, wait up! There he is! Little Cameron, I mean Theo. Where do you think you're going, huh? Are you trying to get to the lab before me so you can get the better Pokemon? Well, that ain't gonna happen. Because I'm gonna get the strongest one first. Try to keep up, squirrels! Alright. I love how the music changed when he showed up. That was cool. Bambo, or Professor Pokemon Professor. Hey, if it isn't Squirrels! And, your friend Tommy, was it? Honestly, Pops, you can't even remember my name. It's Theo! Theo! I feel like with the name of Theo, he should have, like, a slight New York accent. So, I may or may not stop pronouncing my R's occasionally when I read his dialogue. Right, Theo. You're just in time. Today is a very special day for both of you. It's your very first day as field research assistants at Bambo Pokemon Research Labs. Your job will have you traveling across Tandor, observing and capturing many different kinds of Pokemon to help me with my research on Pokemon elements. I have three Pokemon here that will aid you on your journey. Before you get your starters, though, you both will take the Pokemon Trainer Aptitude Test. Oh, so okay. So I was watching somebody else play the beginning portion of this game, I think on IGN or something, and this test will help determine what my first Pokemon will be. So I'm not actually going to be the one picking it, apparently. I think. Test? I didn't study for any test. I thought you were going to give us a rare, powerful Pokemon. Now, don't worry. It's not the kind of test you have to study for. It's just a way to determine what kind of Pokemon trainer you will be. Different starter Pokemon are better suited for different battle styles. A starter Pokemon will be your lifelong partner, so it's important for you to work well together. Yeah, I get it. Enough talking. I want to get my Pokemon. Sheesh, kid. You're not very patient, are you? All right. If you want to know more about what's on the test before we begin, you can talk to my aide. Now, Skwirls, are you ready to take the trainer aptitude test? I think I'm ready. Let's do this. Excellent! So, without further ado, when you encounter a new kind of Pokemon in the wild, what is your first reaction? Alright, I attack it right away, wait and see what it does, throw a Pokeball at it. Well, it's cool because I want to say that these colors probably are indicative of leaning towards what type of Pokemon we're going to get. So, you know, if I answer this, I'm probably leaning towards fire, leaning towards grass, leaning towards water, and so on. I want to lean towards water because I almost always want a water Pokemon, but I'm going to try to do my best to answer this the way I would actually answer it. So I would wait and see what it does rather than just immediately attack it. So let's do that. Very good, both of you. Come on, that was easy. Give me a tougher one. A tougher question, like these questions are actually have right or wrong answers. Okay, next question then. Which of these TMs would you prefer to teach your Pokemon? Hyper Beam, Protect, or Hidden Power? Okay, so if it was depending on the Pokemon, I would say like Hyper Beam is a great choice. Protect is also a great choice, but I feel like with Hidden Power, like that's your clutch move, right? Like any Pokemon could benefit from a Hidden Power depending on what it is. So in this case, I do feel like blue is my better answer. Hey Professor, what's a TM anyway? I'll tell you later. Let's move on with the next question, shall we? Which of the following Pokemon would win in an all-out battle? So, Gyarados is obviously pretty beast, but Gliscor has his moments as well. I feel like Ampharos is probably, like, the least likely to win in these, but definitely Gyarados is, like, beast, right? Like, if you get a Magikarp, like, all you care about is whether or not he's actually going to get to Gyarados, right? And if you've been playing Pokemon Go, you need, like, a bajillion Magikarps. I'm gonna go with Gyarados. Is it possible to fail this test? No, it isn't. Now, this is your final question, so answer it honestly. So I believe I've answered one of each color at this point. What is your motivation for becoming a trainer? Becoming the very best, exploring the region, making new friends. So, honestly, if I had to, like, okay, you're going into a Pokemon game, you always say you want to be the very best, but at the same time, this is a brand new game, and I'm really curious about exploring the region. Making new friends, I mean, it's an online game, I could make new friends, but I think I'm going to go with exploring the region. I feel like if I do this, then it's going to give me the grass-type Pokemon, but these are brand new Pokemons. Pokemon, is Pokemon the plural of Pokemon? Anyway. These are all brand new Pokemon, 200 brand new Pokemon that we're looking at here, 3 brand new starters. I haven't really taken an in-depth look at them, but I feel like if I answer this green one, then it's going to give me the green one. And I usually like the water ones better. But I'm going to answer this honestly. I'm really intrigued to explore the region, so let's do that. No question about it, I'm going to be a Pokemon Master. Ain't nobody's going to stand in my way. Haha, I dig your spirit, kid. Well, that's it for the trainer aptitude test. Now it's time to analyze your results. Here we go, moment of truth. Okay, I finished my analysis. Let's see. Skwirls? You seem to be a trainer who likes to play it safe. Okay, sure. Patience and endurance are your biggest assets. You know that the best things in life come to those who wait. A defensive trainer like you, there it is. Green, called it.
But, oh, okay. Orchinx. Orchinx is the best pick. So it looks, it looked like a cool little cat grass type Pokemon. That was interesting. Go ahead and take it, Skwirls. And I don't believe it's going to give me the option to change it. So here we go. Skwirls achieved, obtained Orchinx. Would you like to give it a name? So normally if I was doing some kind of Nuzlocke or, you know, Nuzlocke Soul Link, then yeah, we give them nicknames. But since we're talking about literally like brand new Pokemon, I think I'm going to go ahead and leave it at Orchinx so that I can get used to its actual name. Oops. Hey, I'm tired of waiting. Squirrel's got the starter already. When do I get mine? I'm done analyzing your results too, Theo. Hmm. So I wonder if he's going to give him the fire one based on his answers, which maybe should have meant I really should have gone with the water one. Oh, man. Oh, man. Well, you certainly know what you want out of life. You're impulsive, impatient, and care mostly about your own desires, but I sense something else in you. Could it be a sense of greatness, the potential to transform yourself completely? Or maybe it's just that you're so young, I can't tell. Regardless, for a trainer like you... Oh, it gave him the water one! Okay, so technically, I mean, if he's water and I'm a grass, then I should have some kind of advantage over him, right? Yes, my first Pokemon! Squirrels, you have a Pokemon, and now I have a Pokemon, too. You know what this means, right? We have to battle. Oh, please not in the lab. Well, I guess we're battling in the lab. Sorry, bud. Squirrels versus Theo. Rival Theo would like to battle. Rival Theo sent out Elitux. Go, Orchinx! So this is a pretty sweet interface that we've got here. It's familiar, of course. I like that, of course, the menu is up here because we've only got one screen that we're looking at, unlike in the latest 3DS games. So let's go ahead and fight. I've got Scratch and I've got Growl. I'm going to go ahead and give him a Scratch. Well, that's interesting. Look at his health bar in the top left. I can't actually see how much health he has. All right, Scratch. Not very effective. So we're pretty even neck and neck right now, which is cool. Oh, he's been fighting with Water Gun, but fortunately I'm Grass type, or at least I think I'm Grass type. I haven't actually looked at it yet. That's kind of interesting that he starts with Water Gun and I don't start with any Grass type moves. Fortunately, I'm going first, so it looks like I've got the speed bonus here in my favor. Yeah, I think we're gonna win this battle here. And of course, I do have that potion if worse comes to worse. Alright. Here we go, is this it? Bam! What a static. I'm paralyzed. Wow, so apparently he has a move to where when he faints, static causes me to get paralyzed. That's cool. So he's probably a water and electric type, and I'm what? Grass and maybe steel? That's my guess based on my tail. Rival Theo, yes. But I was supposed to win! Sorry, bud. Cool. Our first battle! How? I'm supposed to be the best trainer ever! Well, one, I'm older, kid. That's impossible. Good trainers never lose. Please don't cry, Theo. Here, I'll heal your Pokemon for you. Your Pokemon were healed. Sweet, he healed all of us. I wanted to be an unbeatable trainer. How come I couldn't win? I really, really wanted to win. Well, between your starter and Squirrels, theirs has the type advantage. Water beats fire, fire beats grass, and grass beats water. So I wonder if they intentionally gave him the weaker Pokemon instead of the stronger Pokemon like tradition. That's the elemental type triangle, well, one of them at any rate.
Learning to master type matchups is an important part of being a trainer. No way, I want a do-over. How come Squirrels gets the better starter? It's not fair. I'm going home. Alright, see ya, kid. Well, that was an interesting turn of events. He took that harder than I hoped. But you shouldn't be so quick to judge him. He is just a kid after all. I expect he'll soon discover that training Pokemon isn't as easy as he imagined. I'm going out to the entrance to Route 1 by the edge of town. Bring Theo, and I'll teach you both how to catch a Pokemon. See you later, Squirrels. Alright, cool. So he's actually going to teach us how to catch Pokemon. Alright. So that's pretty, pretty sweet. So we're going to head to the edge of the... We're going to head to the edge of town. We got our first Pokemon. Let me actually see if I can... Alright, so X brings that up. Okay. So bag, Pokemon. Let's see what our Pokemon actually looks like here. Oh, whoops. Pokemon. So, summary. Orchinx, Dex type number one. So this is literally number one in the Pokedex here. Orchinx, Grass and Steel. Called it. Called it. Grass and Steel. All right. Experience points, 196. I need 20 to my next level. Timid nature. Likes to run. Oh, okay. Attack, defense. All right. All right. Ability Battle Armor. Can I... Okay, the Pokemon is protected against critical hits. That's pretty sweet. I can't be critically hit. Nice, nice. Alright. That's pretty sweet. Pretty sweet. So we got our first Pokemon here. We're coming up on the end of our time here for this episode, but it's been pretty awesome so far, right? So at the beginning of next episode, we're gonna go to the edge of town, and we are going to learn how to catch a Pokemon. And see some new Pokemon in this new world of the Tandor region. Hopefully you're liking Pokemon Uranium. I think it's a pretty sweet developed game so far. Really excited to dive into it with you guys. Leave some comments, like and subscribe as always. Till next time, guys, stay squirrely. Catch you on the next episode.